Good evening from New York. I'm Chris Hayes. We're 3 weeks away from the midterm elections. Frankly, we have no idea which party will control the House or the Senate. Now, we've got a pretty good picture of what this version of the Democratic Party, the current Democratic Party, will do with that power because we've been seeing it over the past 2 years. Now, when you're running as the opposition party, as Republicans currently are, you don't have to be that concrete. You can just run against the status quo. You can complain about gas prices and the cost of living. Inflation's 8%. But with Republicans within striking distance of retaking the House, probably favored to retake the House, you got to ask yourself, what would that actually mean? Not just on the campaign trail. What would a Republican governance, a Republican majority in the House actually look like? What would a Republican majority in the House actually look like?
You stupid.
And the first thing you need to understand is that it will not look like the last Republican House. The last time Republicans held the House, 2017, 2019, remember, they had unified control of the government. They controlled the House, the Senate, the White House. Donald Trump was the newly inaugurated president. In that period of unified governance for the Republicans, the Trump administration, right, that Congress did not really accomplish any of Trump's big priorities.
Bullshit.
It took nearly 1 year into the Trump administration, but Republicans in Congress are on the verge of giving the president his first big legislative win.
The president today signing that tax cut bill into law, surrounded by cameras in the Oval Office.
He couldn't even get Congress, his Congress, with Republicans, to fund his border wall, his signature political issue. He couldn't even get Congress, his Congress, with Republicans to fund his border wall.
Well, there's more breaking news tonight. This on Capitol Hill, the House is giving President Trump what he wants, a mammoth funding bill that includes new money for his border wall and money to fund part of the governance.
The House of Representatives passed that bill, giving President Trump more than $5 billion for his border wall.
He couldn't even get Congress, his Congress, with Republicans to fund his border wall.
We did it tonight in the House. I mean, just a few minutes ago it passed, even though last week in the Oval Office, Nancy Pelosi said the House can't get the votes to pass a border security wall, funding for a border security wall. We just did a few minutes ago, got 217 votes. I think the Democrats had 185.
Interestingly, the fact that this did pass in the House means that the president called Nancy Pelosi's bluff, and he was right. You'll remember that last week when they were all sitting there in the Oval Office, he kept saying, I can get the House to pass the money for my border wall. I can do it in a minute. And Nancy Pelosi kept saying, you don't have the votes. You don't
That's
have
right.
the votes. If you had them, you would do it. Just go ahead and do it. Prove it. Well, he did prove it tonight. And in fact, this measure passed by a pretty significant margin.
He couldn't even get Congress, his Congress, with Republicans to fund his border wall. Part of the problem was he promised for 2 years that Mexico would pay for it, which it didn't.
When I say Mexico's going to pay for the wall, do you think they're going to write a check for $20 billion or $10 billion or $5 billion or 2 cents? No, they're paying for the wall in a great trade deal. You had the worst trade deal anywhere in the world in NAFTA. We lost thousands of businesses, millions of jobs. And now we have a great trade deal. Billions and billions of dollars a year will be made now, as opposed to NAFTA, which was a disaster. You know that. Everybody knows that.
For 2 years that Mexico would pay for it, which it didn't, which meant that we all had to. And he didn't really get his wall. Instead, in the big major legislative pushes, Republicans did what Mitch McConnell, Washington lobbyists, and rich GOP donors wanted. They do what they always do. What is it? They cut taxes for the rich.
He calls the tax cuts a Christmas present to the middle class.
What is it?
A Christmas present to the middle class. And most Americans will see their taxes go down.
And they spent months bogged down trying to repeal Obamacare, which they ultimately failed to do.
Collins Ms. voted Baldwin. No. Murkowski voted no. But McCain didn't answer when his name was called. He'd walk in seconds later, stand in front of McConnell, and ask for the clerk's attention.
Mr. Peters.
No. No. So that was the last time, but different this time. Because if Republicans take back the House, first of all, the establishment will not be nearly as powerful as it was back then. The new House will be a party of Republicans who want to wreak havoc, who want to destroy American institutions, who operate on trolling and low trust just for the sake of it. This is the party of Matt Gaetz, Lauren Boebert, Jim Jordan, and of course, Marjorie Taylor Greene. But here's the other thing you got to keep in mind. With a presidential election coming up and Joe Biden in the White House, it will be in the short-term interests of the Republican House to make conditions in the country as bad as possible. It's just simple. The worse things are for the country while Joe Biden is president, the better Republicans have a shot at retaking the White House in 2024. As we said, these Republicans have every incentive to intentionally wreck the economy if it means kneecapping Democrats in 2024.
You're goddamn right.
Yeah, fuck you. I'm white, bro. I ain't apologize for shit. You don't like that I like my skin color, then you can suck my dick. I like open gun laws. I like drunken bar brawls. I like drinking Budweiser. I like smoking Marlboro. We monstered up in them monster trucks, rolling in heavy machinery. We all believe in protecting what's ours. If you fuck with us, we got that heavy machinery. Drink beers in a lawn chair. Nothing much going on here. Probably get a few long stares. Look, you don't belong here. Hey, please don't get mad at me. I did not put up the barrier. People are judging me for my exterior. Many of serious say the word white and they act like they're furious. Mad child and I'm sick as fuck. White boy in my pickup truck. Shotguns, my girl's muddy. I'm a firecracker. We lit it up. We just living our best life. Don't wrap us up some wax scandal. Beer and blood on a white beater. Jacked up on Jack Daniels. Get my chicken at Colonel Sanders. Judge me and I'll backhand him. Tom, pass me that red mask and I'll beat his ass with an axe handle.
We're coming up the 31% grade. Yesterday, down where the bulldozers are, we placed from the dozers up to where the excavators are placing panels this morning.